prayer, fasting, supplication, reading your word, because you never know when that opportunity to mother is going to come to you. One time my daughter was needing some guidance, and she was pretty quick to say what's on her mind, one of them. And so she came to me, and, you know, I was trying to dance around and be politically correct and give an opportunity to do some thinking on her own. And she was like, I'm here. I just came to you. I would not have brought the issue if I didn't come here. What you have to say about it? I know what I think, but I need some right thinking. So, you know, we have to keep ourselves prepared for that. We need to be able to take the time. Because I think at the time, I was thinking, it might have been one of those long days I've been traveling and got home. And I don't know, but we need to be able to be prepared to take the time. And I just know that Sister Wayne spends that kind of time. When I first lost my mother, she called and checked on me several times, and I was like, wow. You know, I was a bit uncomfortable because I'm a giver, but I don't receive well. And I had another sister that took care of me well, and I had to learn how to receive that. But you too, as you mother or someone, need to be prepared and built up and take the time, because that responsibility is great for us as mothers, and the rewards are even greater. Not even just looking toward the prize of the high calling, but the reward of seeing the fruit of your labor.
Yes.
When I go back home to our former church, I'm looking up going, hi, Sister Deborah, how you doing? You can't give me your name. I forgot. But, you know, they are able to share something, or you see that they have been successful or been encouraged to when you know better, you do better. And, you know, I thank God for that being able to even see the rewards and fruit of my labor. So today, I want to encourage each of us mothers to recommit, or each of the ladies. You know, we have our organization, Women of Excellence. You know, some of you come, and some of you, and we've got schedules and all kinds of things. I encourage you to come out to that, but as Women of Excellence here at Northside, I encourage you to recommit to fulfilling this humble privilege to be called a mother, to be like a mother, to mother someone, to look after, to take care of, watch over, provide for, tend to. Sometimes you need to go there and wash some dishes. You know, give a young mother a day out. My sister's a real big gap between us. It's about 20 years between us. And so I have a little sister that sometimes you see me missing. I go back, and you know, my mother's laws are really, she's getting there, but I praise God. That I go back, and she has little ones, 3 and 5, and what is he, 10, 12? 12, and so, tending to, sometimes I go to give her that opportunity, her husband, work shift work, and so they're trying to juggle and manage, and they don't have grandma anymore, so I do those things to try to encourage her and to tend to her needs. And you know, I'm not trying to take place of mother, I'm just mothering, because I know that's so important and helpful to us. We want to be protecting. We want to spend some time nursing and nurturing someone. I encourage you to support someone's life today by taking on that awesome high calling of mothering. I praise God for you today, and I thank God for giving me this opportunity. And you all the mothers in the house, be blessed and enjoy your Mother's Day.
Amen. Well, didn't I promise you that you would be blessed?
Amen.
Amen. As I sat there and listened to Sister Deborah, it was almost like sitting around a fire, hearing a fireside chat. Just words of wisdom and just soaking it all in and saying, yes, yes, yes. Just practical stuff that you could use. And we hope that this has been a day that it has been practical information that you can use, that something you can take back with you. What a shame it is to come to the house of the Lord and leave and say, oh, we had a good time today. And someone asks, what did you learn? What was accomplished? And you can't tell them. But when you're able to depart, I always say that when you can depart from this place, having received a rich blessing of the Lord, and having internalized something that you can take with you and say, yes, I can use that. I can use that. Yeah, that's good. That's good. And that's what I was sitting there thinking. That's good, Sister Deborah. That's good. Those are words of wisdom. Let's give her another. Her, I thought, I went back to something I said earlier. It does indeed take a village to rear children. She talked about mothering. If you have not given, you're not a birth mother to a child, then you can mother someone. How many people are there that, although they have a natural mother, that they don't really have a mother? So many mothers in the line of work that I worked in for 30, almost 30 years, I saw so much abandonment that, I mean, they just didn't care. You know, the children were gone. And I cannot begin to tell you, that's good, Steph, give me a little song music there. I cannot begin to tell you the many children that I saw that told me, Mrs. Hill, I hate my mother. Oh, no, you don't do that. No, when I grow up, I will never speak to her again. And I can recall those times when seeing children come in, foster parents being in a foster home, and they come in to visit. One, I must tell you this. One little boy that came in, I picked him up from his foster home many, many years ago. And it was a week before Mother's Day. And he had, in his own little way, made a special little card for his mother. And he was so proud, he showed it to me and says, look, Sister, what I made for my mother. I said, oh, I almost called his name. I'll give him a name, Joe. That's not his name. Joe, that is so nice. I'm sure she'd be glad to get that. So I took him to the office and we waited 15 minutes. Mother didn't show. 20 minutes, mother nowhere to be found. 30 minutes, mother didn't show. And we had a rule that after 30 minutes, if they didn't show, we took them back home. And I can tell you, tears came to my eyes when on the way back to that foster home, when I took him, he said to me, Lucille, where is my mother? Why didn't she show up? I said, well, probably, Joe. Something probably happened, and she'll probably call me next week and give an excellent explanation as to why she was not there. But that was not the case. I didn't lie to him, but I could not reinforce his hurt anymore because I knew where she was. She was with a boyfriend who was more important than her son. And I've seen it year after year after year. So, I want you to be mindful of what Sister Deborah said. When you can step in to be a mother or to mother or help someone else, please do so. Because you never, never know the hurt that some of these children have gone through. You look on the outside, but you don't know what they've experienced on the inside. I've seen 30 years of it. And I know they hurt. And I know there are many times when they need somebody just to love on them, just to care for them and say, you're okay. It's going to be okay. So I want you to really think about those words seriously that she imparted to us today. To share. There's a high calling reach down deep within inside of you and give to someone else. Yes, maybe you didn't give birth to that child.